I've been drinking mimosas since 6 a.m. Woo!
Hello, friends, and welcome back to Red X, your source for the freshest daily Reddit content anywhere on the entire internet. Promise, swearsies, totallys. Today, we're getting back into r/entitledparents because you know I miss it so much. We might do 2 days in a row. I don't know. You just can't tell how this thing's gonna go. But I do know we're doing it today, so without any further delay, let's jump right into that first story. Entitled neighbor accuses me of being a pedo because I refuse to wash his car. Yeah, you read that right. I bet he's the pedo, and OP was like gonna wear a little speedo or something. Never mind. So I never really thought I'd be posting here ever, but this happened this morning. For a little background, I'm a 19-year-old in India, and today our state government eased some lockdown restrictions so my father could reopen his showroom. Hence, he asked me to wash the car, and I thought I needed to wash my motorcycle as well, so why not? EN, entitled neighbor. NK, nice kid. 18-year-old girl, actually, but kid because she's the child of the neighbor in question. Dad, my dad. Me, good old me, your very own OP. That kind of rhymes, I like that. Got some flow. So I live with my parents for the time being because of the ongoing pandemic, and I try my best to help at home because why not? So today, since the restrictions eased a little bit, Dad wanted me to reopen his showroom and so he needed the car. But because he was busy with his stock market stuff, he told me to go wash the car, so I said yes. Because in a brown household, okay, you seldom get a choice. XD, JK, I just wanted to help. Brown household, I'm kinda, it's kinda punched to the gut. What the hell? I go outside with a bucket of water and a rag to wash the car with, and when I'm halfway done, entitled neighbor walks out of his house to pick up the newspaper. He sees me washing the car, and this is what happens. Entitled neighbor,
hey, OP, what a good son washing his dad's car.
OP, good morning. It's nothing. I try to help wherever I can. Entitled neighbor,
that's really nice. So, Dad's opening the showroom today?
OP, yeah, finally, there's some easing of restrictions, so... Entitled neighbor,
hey, since you're already out with the bucket and my car's right there, why don't you give mine a wash after you're done with yours? It's not like you're working a job and you're free at home, so, wash mine too.
OP, Uncle, I'm actually in the middle of a project with my professor, and I need to attend a call in 20 minutes, so... I don't think I can. Side note, when you're Indian, you're taught to respect elders at all times, no matter how stupid or disrespectful they are towards you, or comments about your lifestyle or intellect or look or background. So is uncle like a term of endearment? I guess it could be. I don't know. Entitled neighbor,
oh really? If you were really working such important projects with your professor, then why did you only get 73% in class 12?
FYI, class 12 is the final year of school, and its score is important, but I was going through some stuff, which is why I couldn't score very well. How does he know my score? Because Indian neighbors will pester you until you tell them. However, class 12 was 2 years ago, and I've been doing pretty great since I joined uni, and was taken under the wing of my professor, who did his PhD in the US, and is a renowned researcher in the field of computer science. Hell yeah, dude. My wife had gone for computer science, too. OP, a little irritated, obviously. Uncle, not that it's any of your business, but I'm actually part of an exclusive research group based in the US, and my parents know this, and they're proud that their son is part of a group that has funding from the US government. Entitled neighbor,
but you still can't wash an extra car. What's the point of whatever it is that you're doing? Learn how to talk to your elders with respect.
OP, why don't you tell Nice Kid to wash your car? At this point, I think I could just go back to washing Dad's car, and that'll be the end of it. Boy, was I wrong. Entitled neighbor,
what did you say to me? How dare you suggest Nice Kid wash the car? You just want to see her, don't you? You're a pedophile who's been eyeing my daughter since she was 17. As punishment, you'll wash my car, and that's that.
At this point, I've had about enough, and I'm about to fire away with insults, but Nice Kid, who's my friend, comes in, along with my parents, coming out of the house because of the commotion. Nice Kid, while I'm explaining what happened to my parents.
Dad, I just heard what you said. OP is my friend, and he's been together with one girl since the last 3 years, and his parents know their relationship as well. So please, stop making a commotion, and let's go back inside. I'll wash the car. Entitled neighbor.
No, no, no. I've seen how he looks at girls. He's a pedo.
Dad, entitled neighbor, stop right now. My son is in no way obligated to wash your car, and he will not. Also, he doesn't care about your daughter. He's been in a relationship since 3 years, and we know, and we're fine with it. So don't make a commotion and just back off. Entitled neighbor, still hurling insults toward my family as to how we are uncultured because I have a girlfriend and my parents are okay with it. Screaming even. I guess because arranged marriage. Dad, go back inside right now if you don't want to be punched in the face by me. I'll call the members of the neighborhood and we'll see who's right after that. Now, my dad has a pretty loud voice, and when he yells, it's really scary. Also, the fact that he's over 6'2" adds to the scare, so entitled neighbor just mumbled something and went back inside. So, that's when I realized that my neighbor's absolutely nuts. And then I realized that my call was almost about to start. Whoops. So I ran back in and got to work, and my dad told me that he'll finish washing the car. Please be gentle if editing is screwed. I'm on mobile. Your editing's a lot better than some other stories that I was thinking about reading today. Like this one! Giant wall of text. Ugh. So obviously, entitled neighbor is pretty dumb on multiple fronts. Yeah, I like how he's just casually like, hey, why don't you wash my car too? It's like, bro, you're not doing anything. You're out here watching me wash my dad's car, so why don't you wash your car while you're doing nothing? And then calling people a pedo because you can't even pull that card. Your daughter's already 18, but he's like, yeah, but he looked at her when she was 17. India sounds kind of a lot like the Philippines. There's like a lot of chismis going on, you know, which is just gossip, basically. So don't tell nobody nothing. That's the rules that I live by. It's on a need-to-know basis. It's called OPSEC, all right? Operational security, which I guess I don't do very well at because I'm here on the computer like, hey, everybody, my wife's in computer science, too. I don't tell the university, but it probably wouldn't be that hard to guess. I guess we're all dumb sometimes. But anyways, let's hop into the next story. Entitled family forces me to babysit for the entire weekend and makes me miss my mother's birthday. Forces me to babysit. How's that work? So let's start. I'm Ghanaian. Ghanaian. I'm Ghanaian. That sounds wrong. We'll roll in with it. And if anyone knows anything about West African dysphoria, you know that Ghanaians and Nigerians share a lot in common and often find themselves in the same communities. Also, if anyone has met any entitled African parent, you will understand the theater that is surviving to them. I have many stories to fill a whole novel, but let's start small. So the entitled family. Cast. Entitled mother, EM. Entitled father, EF. Entitled kids, EK1 and 2. This is a Nigerian family that had moved into our little town and naturally entered my parents' circles and therefore became family friends. This started the process of them becoming a thorn in our family's sides. The event I'll mention is what severed ties between our families. So, after a couple of years living in our town, they moved to the nearby city where entitled father got a nice job as a consultant, doctor, in cardiology. Good for them, but when they moved, they put entitled kids in private school and became integrated into the high society, and my city is a very affluent city in the UK. If their entitlement was a 6, they were now a 12. Once in a while, when they wanted to go to their high society parties, I would be asked to babysit their entitled kids for the night. I didn't mind. I got on with the kids as I established that I am not one to F with. If they obeyed the rules, they were rewarded, but I had no qualms punishing these kids and held firm to my boundaries. Once they understood, they were mostly well behaved. In fact, I got way better at parenting the kids than they were. When I gave instructions, they obeyed. They didn't even obey their parents' instruction. Anyway, I have a busy life juggling a master's with a job, so usually when I babysit at night, I usually had plans for the rest of the day after, but as time went on, the entitled parents kept ignoring my plans and finding ways to make me stay the rest of the day, like forcing me to go to church with them and conveniently stopping in the mall for hours when they were meant to drive me home. I lived about a 40-minute drive away from them. No matter how much I protested, they kept finding ways. Anyway, the event. I was asked to babysit whilst they went to dinner on a Friday night. My mother's birthday was on Saturday, so I made it abundantly clear that I had to leave in the morning to spend the day with my mom. They said they'll drop me home by 9 a.m. on Saturday. I agreed. They went to their party, I played with the kids, and after a fun bubble bath, I sent them to bed. Around 2 a.m., the entitled parents have still not arrived, and I went to sleep. I woke up around 7 a.m. and realized that they were still not home. I rang them to find out where they were, and this was the phone call. OP, Auntie, African custom to call older females aunt, whether they're related or not. Please, where are you? You said you would drop me home today. Entitled mother.
Oh, OP, the party ran late. Are the kids okay? Is something wrong?
OP, the kids are okay. We're just wondering where you are and when you're coming home. Entitled mother.
Oh, we're in a hotel room. We have a meeting all day today, and we'll be back Sunday. And also, I've been drinking mimosas since 6 a.m. Woo!
They had lied and gone to London for the weekend. OP, Auntie, I can't stay the weekend. I have to go to my mom's for her birthday. Entitled mother.
I'm sure your mother will understand if you miss it, as you're busy with our children.
OP, no, she won't. My mother is dramatic. And you promised me. Maybe I can take them home with me. Entitled mother.
No, no. There's no way you should take them on public transport. I don't want them sitting on a dirty train.
OP, but I have to go home. Entitled mother.
No, no. Stay. Stay with the children and don't take them anywhere. Do you hear me? It's not like I left you with nothing. You should be grateful that I cooked for you. Small thing I ask of you and you're being disrespectful. Where are your manners? Didn't your mother raise you to respect your elders? One weekend with children and you're throwing a tantrum? I feel sorry for your future children.
Oh. Oh. Call child services. Bye. She hung up and refused to pick up my calls. I rang my mother and told her the situation. I'm upset, she's upset, and the best way to fight an entitled African parent is to send another African entitled parent to battle with them. Oh, it's like Godzilla. The only one who could beat Godzilla is another Godzilla. Well, and Mothra. Anyways, my mother's been a mother longer than her and has mastered the African mother dramatic manipulation technique. So my mother rings her and lays into her. My mother rings again and tells me to take care of the children for the weekend, but this will be the last time that I ever babysit for that family. So I stayed the weekend and dealt with entitled kid shenanigans. My parents arrive on Sunday to pick me up, and together, we wait for the entitled parents. Now bear in mind, I don't know what went down in the phone call between to the sets of parents, but when the entitled parents arrive, they look shook. The minute they see my mother, they are scared. They don't even say anything to me. The entitled father just pushed 150 pounds into my hands, and my mother drags me into the car. The entitled parents lock the door in a hurry, and my parents are fuming in silence on the way home. I have never seen such animosity. Anyways, that was the last time I ever saw that family. Ever again. Like I said, I have more stories of entitled family and family friends. My mom has one of the most JN families in existence. And if you want some stories, let me know and I'll tell. Oh, just no families. Just no. I'd like to hear more about your mom's family. Heck yeah. I gotta admit to being like a little frustrated with OP in the story because you shouldn't let yourself get pushed around, but I do understand being a kid as well, so maybe you couldn't help it, and yeah, cultural thing is a factor. It's kind of hard for me to identify with because, you know, I'm American, so we do whatever we want. How often do you meet an American that gets told no, and they're just like, yeah, okay, I guess I'll deal with it. Those kids are going on public transit. I don't care what the mom said. You didn't want your kids to go on the bus? I guess you should have been here. I gotta go to my mom's birthday. Later. And then make them come pick the kids up. Another 40-minute drive after their trip from London, however far away that is. That's the way to do it. You don't just bend over. God. But anyways, let's get into one more story and then I'm gonna get out of here. I got a lot of stuff to do today. But you know I gotta make the videos for y'all. So let's jump into it. Entitled mother sticks her head through my service window and tries to steal an old lady's ice cream. Boss has no patience for it. I worked at a little ice cream shack over the summer. We get some entitled rude people, but this is the best story that I have from there, and the most memorable. It was my fourth day on the job, and I had just finished the training. My boss, we'll call her Kate, that's awfully close to Karen, OP, be careful, was watching as I took an order for a dad and his 9-year-old daughter. They were the first in line. The dad gets a milkshake and the daughter gets a soft serve ice cream. No big deal. I get the order out just as we get the 7 p.m. rush, which happens every day. Kate and I take orders and make them like crazy, trying to move as fast as we can, but there are 10 people in line. We get down to the last few people, and she was just handing out someone else's order. In the middle of me making a hot fudge sundae, a woman sticks her head through my window and starts yelling her order at me. I give her the response that I would be happy to take her order once I finish the one I'm already working on and to please wait outside. I hand out the first sundae, and she pushes an old lady, who was part of the group I took the order of and who was waiting for her ice cream, out of the way, and starts telling me her order. I said I had to finish my order I was already on, and she says, "How it's ridiculous to make her and her son wait in a line for this long!" I ignored her, and continued to make this poor old lady's sundae, and the mom tries to freaking take it. I pulled her back inside fast enough and told the old lady to have a seat and I'd be right with her, went out the back door, and personally brought it to her with a spoon and some napkins. I ignored the entitled mom as I went back inside, almost running into Kate, who had just handed out her last order. I came around to the window, and the woman starts yelling at me about how rude I was to her and her son. I still haven't seen her son, so I assumed that he was in her car, and the old lady she pushed out of the way was laughing at her from her table. Kate looks the mom dead in the eyes through her window, leans over the register, and closes the window while she's still yelling. "That's enough of that. No one treats my workers that way," she said, and began cleaning up, completely ignoring the still screaming woman outside. The old lady came up to the window again once the mom had stormed off and handed me a $5 tip. "You're one of the sweetest girls I've met around here. Don't mind what anyone else says." That's the end. The rest of the night went smoothly, and we got $40 in tips that night. Dang, they tipping at the ice cream stands? I'm gonna go get a job over there. What's up? I'm glad entitled mother didn't get her ice cream. I wonder if she actually had a son. I bet the son was like, you know, the 30-year-old dude that lives in her basement. And he's like, "Go get me some ice cream, woman, and another beer." Crazy, crazy days. But at least it does make a good story. I hope that you guys enjoyed all of these stories today. And if you did, I hope that you will like, comment, and or subscribe. Keep yourself safe out there. Join us again tomorrow for some more crazy Reddit stories. And please do not forget to wash your hands. As soon as this episode is over, go do it. Oh, look, it's over.